Greetings and salutations, and welcome to World Anvil's Advanced Interactive Maps Code. If you haven't already, make sure you check out the quick basic guide to maps, where you can learn how to upload a map and quickly drop in pins. In this video, I'm going to take you through the map edit interface on World Anvil and help you fine-tune those fancy interactive maps. Ooh yeah. You can reach the edit map interface either by clicking the spanner in the general maps interface of your world, or by clicking the Edit Map button in the sidebar of the presentation mode. The Map Edit interface has four main sections: markers, marker groups, layers, and map settings. Let's go through what you can do on each one. Map pins are the basic kind of marker. It's quickest to create pins like this in the presentation mode, but you can drag and drop them into position on the map here too. Choose your pin type from the dropdown, add a title, and an optional description. Labels are map markers which appear as a written label text. You must add a title too. Circles extend from the point of the map pin. Define how big you want your circle to be by typing the radius size in pixels. Lines are, well, literally lines. You can draw them across your map to denote roads or journeys of your characters. To create a line, click the checkbox here, then drag the pin along the map in the interface above. Every time you drop the pin, you'll create a point on your line. Make sure you add a title too. For polygons, use the same drag and drop method to make your points on your polygon. These are great for denoting biomes, the borders of a country, or the districts within a city. For lines, circles, and polygons, you have styling options too. You can define the color, thickness, and opacity, that is, how see-through they are, of lines, polygons, and circles. You can also distinguish between outline and fill for polygons and circles. The power of World Anvil's interactive maps is the ability to link articles and other maps to map pins. You can do this in the Where Does It Link To section. You can link each pin to multiple different kinds of content, which show in the sidebar when the map pin is opened. You can also set your map pin as a direct link. When someone clicks on the pin, the map or article will open directly. In Advanced Options, you can add tags to each pin to help you find them more quickly. You can select a marker group if you've created one. We're going to talk about those next. You can toggle a pin's status from public to private, or show them exclusively to certain people using subscriber groups. To learn more about subscriber groups, check out the Access Rights interface found on the left-hand menu bar. You can also add storytellers or author's reminders to a pin if you have the RPG features enabled. These won't appear to anyone else. Once you've filled in your pin, click the Create Marker. You'll now be able to see it in the presentation mode. Marker groups enable you to have groups of pins which you can toggle on and off. If you're showing a lot of different kinds of information on a single map, they can be really useful. For example, you can create one group of polygons and pins which show political information, and another group showing geographical information, like landmarks and biomes. Being able to toggle between those is really useful, so people can see multiple types of information on the same map. Create a new marker group under the Marker Group tab. Add the name of the group here on the right, and if you want the marker group toggled on automatically when the map loads, click the Initial Group Visibility box. Maybe you want your marker group visible only to one of your players, or only to those who've already read the first book of your series. In Advanced Options, you can make marker groups public or private, or exclusively for your subscriber groups. Once your marker group is created, you can add new pins to it as you create them. To add pins you've already created, go to the Markers tab and click the Add Group icon on each marker to change or add a marker group. Pins can only be in one marker group at a time. Map layers are great for showing the Underdark layer beneath a region, the sewers under a city, or the different levels of a building. You can use them to express things like climate information or air currents as well. Map layers work as alternate base images for your map, and you can toggle between map layers in the presentation mode by mousing over the layers icon at the top right-hand corner. To upload a map layer, go to the Layers tab of the Map Edit interface. On the right-hand side, you can upload your image. You must add a title, and you can add a description if you like. A layer can also be assigned to a marker group, so it toggles on automatically when that marker group is activated. You can assign your layer to a marker group here. The position or weight of the map layer helps you define which order the layers appear in. The layer with the highest number will appear first on the list. You can set layers to public or private, or show them exclusively to subscriber groups. This is a good idea if the layer contains secrets you want safe from your players or readers. Once you're finished, click the Create Layer button and check it out in the presentation mode. The final map tab is the Map Settings, where you can edit the key information about your map. Under the Basic Map Settings, you can edit the title and description of your map. You can also define how much users can zoom in and out of your map. The Legend section allows you to create a legend of your map to give more information about it. You can also add images to this section. If you'd like to add a compass rose to your map, upload the image and select it from the drop-down menu. To upload images, use the blue button if you're a guild member or the Images and Files interface. If you want your map embedded in your articles, copy the code presented here in the Map Embed snippet and just paste it into your article. Remember, guild members can do this even quicker by typing the open square bracket and the title of the map. You can also choose a new primary image for your map here. To change map layers, go to the Layers interface. By default, your maps will automatically load at zero zoom level and in the center. If you want to change that, go to the Initialization section. Select your preferred initial X and Y coordinates and the zoom level. All the information in the Navigation tab defines how your map connects to the rest of your world. You can edit tags, choose articles and a category to attach your map to, and change where the map ranks on your world's homepage. Display and Privacy allows you to add subscriber groups, to make your map private, and select a thumbnail to replace the automatic thumbnail image. You can remove your map from your world's homepage here too. And finally, if you want to delete your map altogether, you can do that under Other Options. Map deletions are non-reversible, so make sure you're certain before you delete it. One last quick tip, you don't just have to use map images in the Interactive Maps interface. Imagine creating species with pins pointing out their anatomical features, or characters with cybernetic enhancements information. There's so much you can do with the Interactive Maps interface. It's probably my favorite tool on World Anvil, and it's definitely the most powerful. If you're looking for more help, check out our documentation, the World Anvil Codex, at worldanvil.com/codex. I've linked the Maps Codex article in the description of this video. Or join our Discord server at worldanvil.com/discord, and you can ask specific questions on our help channel. And make sure you check out our YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/worldanvil for World Anvil tutorials and inspiring world building content. Now grab your hammer and go world build!